VSS oh my goodness, I think away. Gray is he's out in the open, spraying down, not going to connect. Does actually hit a little bit, but not too much. Here in the rest of the ALS, trying to swarm into this position. They know where one is, but where are the rest of the members? As Sei and Lulu gets a kill on the Shadow, gets him dropped down. Not going to finish the job just yet.
And is this the time for Sei to actually get back onto the board? As they failed the first time, this second time, they will not allow All-Star to kind of bring it back. But Benz says no, Lulu gets knocked out, and he has nobody near him to keep or to actually bring him back alive. Now, believe is right below these two.
That beautiful M16 in his hands right now. And again, one of the best things about FPP, you can really appreciate the gun skins.
Yeah, the gun skins, and of course the recoil control that these people have to have. I mean, it's not easy to be able to control those recoils perfectly, but Lulu again left alone here. Wonder if they can revive him. It doesn't look like it's going to be so.
There's not enough time.
And they're hesitating yet again too much here. And AKS gonna get knocked down to half HP as the rest of ALS, however, surrounding that building.
Okay, ALS, they had one member.
See in Miramar right at the beginning, Asura, I'm sure you are going to agree with me. We have another squad up against one another, and INS Joker.
Oh,
that beautiful call I did.
Oh, no.
I think that bullet just brushed the helmet just right off the top.
I thought he was dead.
Not come up, but you know, that can actually be detrimental for these boys because, again, they are just boxing themselves in. They have to do something, and I think, hey, he comes. Shadow spots the enemy, shoots AKS, returns fire, knocks him down. Brilliant reaction time on the part of the boys from Saiyan Legacy.
Now what they need to do is to kind of just play around these corners. The corners are their friend.
There you go. Get
two. They need another two more. Ray is healing right up here. Are they going to charge on, or are they going to be at least a little bit more passive and control themselves? But it seems like Saiyan pulling the trigger, gets another one. One more to remain, and is ALS already out of this game? His foot got clipped.
Oh my.
If you're seeing it right now, Twista has been like going 180, right? Okay, well, they're getting pop shots onto carry. I don't think he's gonna get knocked out or anything here.
Oh, he got revived.
Twista has been, I think BFR are going for a flank maneuver because there's two squads or two members. The most extravagant fraggers out there, but they're a very smart team and they won't just allow themselves to get knocked out pretty early, so they like to just transition. But it seems like their buggy got destroyed, one of their teammates got destroyed, and they have to just revive themselves because now God's Reign is right behind them, sniffing out their victims, and they're going for the charge. Yeah,
they're gonna go for it straight up. They know that they have one knockdown, and this is the perfect time to strike. Like Viper waiting in the desert sands of Miramar, trying to get up, but here's the revive. Will it come just in time? I think he's gonna be able to do it. A little bit of hesitation here from ISO. They haven't committed. There's so many places to hide in Montenueva, just like, say, El Pozo itself. I'm surprised that only Saitama and 18, but that thought, look at
finally.
That rat. It's finally attacked here, time for God's Wrath, and it's going to be a one-for-one exchange right now, but that's going to be a trade kill for the side of God's Wrath, and they're going to be able to clean this up nicely as they do get the kill onto Rapzod and finish the rest of the remaining member off. No backup still coming for BFR.
I wonder what's happening. Fusion and his teammate are nowhere to be seen, and two members from BFR just got wiped out. What's going on?
They went all the way around, and they aren't helping at all. I don't think they have weapons. He's not a fool. He's a smart man. Just get on out of there and be the better person. Be the better player, not just expand yourself out of nowhere. And Red X Official has actually joined in the fight onto God's Reign and Fleek.
One more.
Oh my god.
His display on Fleek, and he survives. Wow.
Wow, that was really, really close. But I just want to go back to the fight between, of course, God's Reign and the boys from BFR. What's interesting is that two members of BFR...
Where the AWM really shines, especially here in Miramar. Just like looking at now the M24, look at this angle.
He's got it! Oh my goodness!
What a headshot from long range!
Point! In a beast. From within, of course, Bhishma is a warrior in Hindu mythology.
So he's a Bhishma.
Oh, hell yes. He is going all out. And right over here, the boys from Orange Rock are putting up all the pressure on Team Hype. Let's see if Team Hype lives up to the hype. He does take a few hits.
Oh, he has a grenade. What the heck? He has a nade.
Oh, my goodness. Imagine if that blew up on time.
Oh! It blew up in his face.
Oh, yeah.
Did he damage
himself?
Yeah. He did. But that was...
Instant.
Audio is a bit more important in this factor. Absolutely. You need to have that pinpoint accuracy, which of course they do have. Shoutouts to the Oppo A9 2020.
That's Team Skull going out on the bottom side as well. That's a
nade. Oh, he didn't know! He's on the corner!
Right past him, and that's going to be a spray down from the staircase coming out. Right there, that's going to be K2S going out!
Oh my goodness. Oh, wow. That's it. That's the end of
rather than your positioning is much better, at least for the scenario when everything is so wide open. And of course, have a good chunk of smokes.
Spray down from long range, it's not gonna connect! That's gonna be Issa Shiv, who has to back up his teammate though from long range. And Burn X-Fleet does take out Manu, but blind spray down, not gonna be able to hit just yet as BYR looks to eliminate. Oh, that's a good one! That's gonna be able to connect! That's a double! Knockdown right there, coming right in! BYR, what a spray from long range!
That is what you came here to watch, that 6x M-Force control on that recoil over there. I mean, obviously, there's something that even I'm trying to learn, but amazing bit of display over here from Aladdin, and he gets the job done.
Long-range double spray down, wow. Amazing here. And that could be another one. Cyan looking to make their mark as Ray does actually put changes the scope right now, puts it on his AK just in hopes of being able to spray someone down from long range as well. And Burn X will take a loss as well.
And this is just... I don't know what's happening anymore here. And slower, we're seeing squads going down left and right, but...
The FPP angle. If you are so used to TPP, and you forget about, you know, just looking left or right, it's going to be a problem.
Oh, look at this. The patience coming in, and the spray down almost takes out Ryzer. One
more bullet! Oh my god!
Is he going to find it? He's trapped in the circle. What's he going to be able to do? He is pinned down. God's Reign literally looking to smite. ISO right here.
Yeah, trying to look for a better angle there. Kill to survive. Ooh, I mean, what happened?
Down Mavi.
You know, I mean, at this point, if I had a betting license, I would have been shouting, place your bets, because this can go any direction right now. Let's not
rule
out the underdogs and Ray under heavy fire. Aladdin again with that spray. This time he switches to a 3x and just rains down death on the enemy. I think I don't see Ray swiping. Ooh, did he just spot him?
Yeah, he saw him just clip the edge right there. Was able to get behind it though. Now BYR is aware of everybody in their vicinity.
In about 15 seconds.
No.
And the distance, it's not just the distance, it's that, you know, they already have that area on lockdown. Of course, if they go in for the revive, the scope is going to be on them, and Nightmare gets a knock and gets knocked out in return.
He was a bit too greedy. He actually went away from the building and was on the perimeter. Never what Juwan would do, but it seems like Sourdeep is going to be able to kind of give his teammate a little bit of cover with that smoke. Burnex Skull is in a very, very bad spot. That's a teeny tiny tree that's going to try to block bullets from every single angle. It's not going to happen. Orange Rock down to the last two members. Burnex Official down to the last one. And it seems like with eight teams remaining, we are already on a top or the rooftop of their structure to kind of get a little bit more vantage point against their opponents. They can basically just prone, right?
You know, had this been TPP, they would have all been up top. Because, you know, you can get a lay of the land around you and all that, because you can see all that. But amazing. And I've got a question for you, Asurai.
Inside my own world of make-believe. Kids screaming in the cradles, profanities. I see the world through ice covered in ink and bleach. Cross out the ones who heard my cries and watched me weep. I love everything. Fire spreading all around my room. My world's so bright, it's hard to breathe, but that's alright. Hush. My weight and glee. I live inside. inside my own world of make-believe. Kids screaming in the cradles, profanities. Some days I